previously.
I don't want to hear it!
You've always said that it's best to be straight with the police, but I think this time it's best if we just stay out of their way.
You need to leave the police work up to the actual police.
I'd like to make an anonymous tip-off about the night of Hamish Roche's death.
They just wanted to ask us some more questions before they decided that we weren't really involved.
Rory, it has been a while.
I'm the one on the left.
We need to face tune as well.
Wear the blue shirt from your pic.
She must have flipped the photo.
You look fantastic.
Thank you. Has Jimmy gone already?
Yeah, he got picked up.
Oh, okay, great. Did Danny message while I was getting ready?
Yeah.
What? Oh, no, he's cancelled.
No, he's looking forward to the date.
David?
He thinks you're Elly. The image on your profile got flipped.
What?
Elly must have done it when she was face-tuning. It was...
No, I'm the one on the left.
I'm so sorry. I should have checked it before I posted it.
This whole thing has been a complete disaster.
No, don't be ridiculous. This is all about you getting back out there.
See? Which is why you should go along tonight anyway, right?
Exactly. Just so he doesn't feel tricked.
Have you thought about this from Danny's side of things? If you disappear, he'll think he's done something wrong.
Okay, well, I'll message him and tell him the truth.
Or do it in person. Aaron and I can tag along in case things go bad. But they might go great. How will you know if you run away?
Well, you have to come too, okay? Otherwise, he'll think that I was catfishing him.
It would be very weird if I was there.
Well, it's your fault Amy's in this situation. You have to come.
Okay, if you want me there, I'll be there.
Okay.
Great, I'll call out.
Apparently there's a leaky tap.
Yeah, the one here. Oh, look.
Mum, they're probably just here for dinner.
Oh, sorry, love. It's just that every time I see them, it makes me think about what we've done.
No, you've got to get that out of your head. The cops got nothing on us. We're safe.
Hey!
Hey.
Hey. So glad that you're back.
Yeah, you okay?
Yeah. All right.
I spoke to the Port Lincoln police about Hamish and Louise's involvement in Dad's death.
So what'd they say?
Well, they're taking the allegation seriously, and the hospital staff are cooperating, so...
Yeah, that's good. That's really good.
But what if it turns out they had something to do with Russell's death? Doesn't that make us look like we have more motive to take out Hamish?
We'll deal with it if it comes to that.
The sergeants already suspect you because of the harassment claim Hamish made. I don't want you taking the rap for this.
I won't. Neither of us will.
Missy. Hey.
Hey. I was sorry to hear about Hamish.
Thank you.
I hope the police figure out what happened soon. Have they told you anything?
Not officially, but once they find Louise, everything will be cleared up.
The nurse, they think she's responsible.
No doubt.
I thought they'd investigate more people in a case like this. I rubbed a lot of people the wrong way.
Well, I'm going to take a shower. Got dinner with Papa tonight.
He's taken all this pretty hard. We all are.
Sorry, I can't imagine what you're going through. Catch you guys later.
Wait. He has to stop being so jumpy.
Yeah, I'll try talking to him tonight.
Yeah. Well, I'm heading out tonight, so you got the place yourself.
Okay.
Oh, there he is. There
Oh, I can't do this.
Yes, you can.
We are here now. You are following through with this.
No. Come on.
Yes. Come on. Let's
go. Work.
Yeah. Up. Let's go.
Amy.
Actually, I'm Amy. So, you know how there were two people in the photo?
You're the other woman. I recognise you.
Yeah. Well, you know how I said I was the one on the left? The photo got flipped.
I get the picture. So to speak.
So, all good then?
Absolutely.
You guys have a great night.
What happened?
It couldn't have gone better.
My shout? What are you having?
Yeah. Wine?
How's one a draft?
Thanks. Hey, how did your exams go today?
Good, I think. Yeah, so just one more to go. Mm-hmm. So nice seeing you two back together again. I'll go in order, shall I?
Thank you. Therese?
Hey, Mum, are you okay?
Yeah. Believe it or not, it's so much harder seeing Gary around than the last time we broke up. I just don't understand why you did it.
Ah! Misty! Come in.
Have I come at a bad time?
Oh, well, we're still both, you know, on edge given everything that's happened in the backyard.
Of course, completely understandable. Yeah. Thank goodness you weren't here when it happened. Sheila said you were both at the hotel.
Yeah, that's right. We checked in at about 10 to 9, then I headed down to the fireworks.
10 to 9, you're sure? Thing is, these hotel records say you checked in at 8:59.
Well, there must be a glitch. We definitely checked in before the fireworks. Why have you got the hotel records?
Did you stay by the lake for the whole show?
Yes, and then we went back to the hotel.
That's what you've told the police?
Yes.
And Sheila, did you tell them about the call you made to Gary?
Mum never made a call.
See, that's strange. I saw you by the lake answering a distressed call from your mother before walking off in the opposite direction to the hotel.
Well, what are you playing at?
If you're covering up that phone call, it'll be on records. The truth will come out. I know you're good people, but a man is dead. Whatever it is you're hiding, you need to come forward.
Yeah, I think it's best you leave.
Go to the police, or I'll have to.
What are we gonna do?
Yeah, we'll be okay.
How can you say that?
But I don't know how Misty got those hotel records. It might be inadmissible evidence.
Oh, but she was right about the call.
Well, we'll just say I forgot. It was about nothing.
I can't live like this. I'm going to go to the police and tell them I did it.
Mum, no.
Well, it's the least I can do, particularly after what you did for me.
What?
What you did for me.
What I did?
Yes. Gary, you're still young and Xanthi needs you, but with your record, they'll throw the book at you. That's why I need to protect you.
Wait, protect me? You didn't kill Hamish.
Of course not. Why would you think that?
Well, you're so upset on the phone. You're going to meet him. Then when I came home, he was lying face down in the spa. I thought you'd offed him for cheating on you.
I thought you'd done it because he cheated on me.
So we've been lying to the police and sucking up to Paul Robinson for absolutely no reason.
Well, that was because you told me we couldn't tell each other what had happened.
Mum, we need to go to the police. Right now.
We have about 20 seconds before Danny gets back from the bathroom.
How's it going?
I'm gonna go home.
What? Why?
He's not into me. He's into you, and that is so fine.
That's all true. You guys had instant chemistry.
I have lost count of how many times he's looked over at you.
Well, maybe he's not looking at Elly. He's just checking out the bar.
Yeah, or he's nervous.
No. It's not that.
Okay, you are psyching yourself out. You need to loosen up and have some fun.
Cool. Okay, he's gone.
Fine.
Hey.
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 They were just saying they're going to check out another bar.
Oh, right. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, I'm so glad we don't have to play these dating games.
Yeah, I forgot how complicated it is.
And now we just get to be straightforward and honest with each other. I was gonna go help Elly with the drinks.
All right. Are you ready to tell us what really happened?
I was at the gala. The 9 o'clock fireworks had just started when I got a call from Mum.
Whoa, Mum, just calm down, Mum, all right? Just tell me what happened. Yeah, all right, I'm coming, Mum. Stay where you are, all right? I'm on my way.
Where were you when you made the call?
I was at home. I was really upset because I just found out that Hamish Roach had been cheating on me with that woman, Louise.
Sorry to hear about that.
Well, I was trying to get onto him and he wasn't answering his phone and I'd worked myself up into a real state. I was so furious, the man didn't even have the guts to talk to me, but then there was a knock at the door. It had to be Hamish come to apologise. But I was so upset, I just stared at the door fuming, and then all of a sudden, I got a text telling me he was out the back. I assumed that he'd gone down the side. So then I called Gary to tell him what had happened. I am so furious, Gary. He's been seeing another woman and now he has the gall to turn up here. Please, you have to come home and deal with Hamish. Sure enough, there he was, out by the spa. Oh, seeing him so close, I had to get out of the house. So I left by the front door.
I thought Mum meant she wanted me to give Hamish a piece of my mind.
That is what I meant.
Yeah, I know that now, but... when I got home, it would have been about 9:15. I got the shock of my life.
Hamish, you out here?
I could tell by the look of him, he was dead. So I tied it up a bit, hoping to make it look like an accident.
Are you saying you tampered with the crime scene?
Yeah. I panicked and was stupid, but I did it to protect Mum. I hated the idea of her going to jail after what Hamish had done to her. After that, I went to find her and she said she'd gone for a walk to calm down. Hey, Mum! Mum!
Oh, Gary, I am so sorry to drag you into this. I am so angry at Hamish. He used me. Gary?
What's the matter, Mum? He's gone. He can't ever hurt you again.
But...
we can't ever talk about it, okay?
But...
we just have to go back to the hotel and... forget tonight about it. Forget it.
So we went to the hotel, checked in, and went straight to bed.
Mm. What time was this?
Oh, it must have been about 10:45, I think.
I hardly slept, thinking about what Hamish had done to me and then what Gary had done to Hamish. I felt sick.
Yeah, it was my idea we not talk about what really happened that night, that we just stick to our stories about staying in the hotel. Mm.
Oh, but I went along with it. Gary can't take the blame for all of this.
No. I'd say you've both been equally foolish.
Whew. It looks dangerous.
Thank you.
Hey guys, sorry to interrupt. The waiter brought this over from you, but I think it was meant to go to Amy, yeah?
No.
You bought her a drink?
I bought you both drinks.
I can get my own, thank you.
You two are quite the pair.
Quite the pair?
Yeah, I like my women like I like my cocktails. Two for one.
Excuse me?
Sorry, weren't you just saying how much you wanted to find a woman you could seriously connect with?
How about the three of us get connected?
Aaron, we need to get the bags. Let's go.
You both could have saved yourself a lot of anguish by telling the truth in the first place.
Yes, we know, Detective Graves. Lesson learned.
Now, I'll be sending some officers home with you to collect evidence. And you should brace yourself for an obstruction of justice charge, Mr. Canning. This confession doesn't prove your innocence.
Yeah, we understand.
I got your text. So it was a misunderstanding. I'm glad you decided to be honest.
Oh, yes, I just didn't know that I got myself so upset, but thank you so much.
Detective Graves gave us a warning, but we're not off the suspect list.
I'm sure you'll be cleared soon, and with your statement to the police, you're that much closer to finding out what really happened.
Okay, well, yeah, this is good. You know, the Cannings haven't done anything wrong. They won't get in trouble. Yeah,
the problem is, officers are scouring their backyard now for new evidence, which means anything could be seized, like the gnome that you hit Hamish with. If there's any prints or DNA on it, it'll put you in the frame until they find the wheeze, if they ever do.
Maybe I should tell the police what I did.
No. No, they'll dismiss Louise and they'll focus on you.
But it's not just the police. Misty was asking us questions today, remember?
Don't worry about the police or Misty. I will take care of it.
Mark, come in.
Yeah, sorry for calling past so late.
Did you just finish work?
Oh, I'm on a break. I've got to head back for the night shift.
Is it weird I miss those crazy hours sometimes?
Yeah. So, I understand that you've been doing some rogue police work, investigating Gary and Sheila.
I couldn't just stand by while your brother's going through so much.
Yeah, I appreciate that. And I understand that you're just trying to help. But I would give the snooping a rest from here on in.
Why?
Well, it's not exactly appropriate. You're not a police officer anymore.
I assisted in a case. Gary and Sheila aren't mad, so why do you have an issue with
it? I'm just warning you for your own good. I don't want you to wind up in trouble without even realising it.
Thanks for your concern, but I know my limitations as a civilian. One sec. Hello? Senior Sergeant Lake, is there a problem? Sure, yeah, I'll be there. Okay. Bye.
What did Lake want?
She wants me to come to the station first thing tomorrow. She mentioned Gary and Sheila.
Right, well, don't be surprised if you get a whack over the knuckles for sticking your nose in where it doesn't belong.
Thanks, guys. Please, if you need anything else, just come back and ask.
It'll be so good to get a decent night's sleep now that that ugly business is all over with.
Yeah.
Love, I know that there's still the obstruction charge, but Detective Graves won't let you go to jail for that.
It's not that that I'm worried about.
Well, what are you worried about?
I broke Therese's heart for nothing.
Oh, well, you can fix that now. Go and see Therese and clear it up.
Where would I even start?
Well, you could tell her it was all my fault. I'm sure she'll understand.
No, Mum, I've messed Therese around enough. I'm going to bed. It's been a long day.
Oh, I'm sorry, Amy.
Oh, stop apologising.
Why can't? It's my fault you went on a stupid date. He was such a jerk.
Yeah, the date was a disaster. But bar hopping with you guys was... It was so much fun.
Exactly. Friendship is way more important. Not men.
Yeah, men suck.
Hey, not all men suck.
Well, after everything I went through with Nick, I'm almost ready to give up on dating altogether.
Oh, maybe not forever. We need to break the bad dating cycle.
Yeah.
Maybe we should use this as a challenge. What do you say to 100 days with no men?
100 days?
Yeah.
What? No men, no nothing. I bet you've said that before.
No. This time it's official, right, Amy?
Yeah. Yeah, you watch us. 100 days. Peace, okay.
Whatever.
Amy and I are strictly off men.
Yeah.
Listen, would you prefer to hold off making a statement till tomorrow?
No. But I have to do it at some point. It's just, I don't really remember that much, and what I do remember, I don't want to talk about.
Okay, darling, I'm gonna be there with you. And if at any point you start feeling uncomfortable, I'll make them stop.
Okay. We're going ready. Sheila.
I just need to talk to you about Gary.
No, I'd really rather you stayed out of this.
I didn't come to have a go. I want to tell you why Gary broke up with you. It was because of Paul Robinson.
What, because of the affair?
No. Paul agreed to give me an alibi for the night that Hamish died.
An alibi?
No, not like that. It was a misunderstanding. Best we don't go into it right now. Anyway, in return for the alibi, Paul demanded Gary break up with you.
What?
I know, it was a horrible thing of Paul to do. But please don't think badly of Gary. He didn't think he had a choice because he was protecting me. And I know that we have had issues in the past. But the truth is, Gary's a complete mess without you. He is so torn up and I cannot bear to see my boy like this. So please, can you find it in your heart to forgive him?
Coming up on Neighbours.
To fresh starts. Mm-hmm. So what about Gary?
Where true love's concerned, there are no barriers to happiness.
Listen, we have had a call from the police.
Mr. Sharma.
Senior Sergeant.
The police are asking questions everywhere. It's only a matter of time before they get a break.
Unmissable drama.